Welcome back from That Should Break. Remember, we are live on Facebook as well as Twitter. All you need to do is make sure that you have some data and OTT in order for you to be able to log in and be able to catch the show live. It shouldn't be the reason as to why you wait for the show from home and get to office late or to your small workplace late. You can always catch it using your mobile phone, using your iPad, using your tablet, using your PC. All you need to do is make sure that you have an internet connection. Now, on our Kachai, like I did mention earlier on, we have a story that of course did get the country by surprise, whereby we had some six people that did lose their lives after a building had collapsed in Kansanga. Now, details coming in on this particular story is that a building in Kansanga has collapsed, killing six people on the spot. The incident occurred yesterday, Wednesday afternoon, along Mitala Road, when the building collapsed by concrete poles caved in the building, barring six builders, I beg your pardon. Now, according to the deputy director, that is, of course, of Fire Safety and Emergency Services, Mr. Hassan Chanda, the dead have been identified as Martin Owori, Robert Okech, James Ocho, Nicholas Ocheng, Joseph Oburu, and Etiang Okong. Police could not readily establish the owner of the building after engineers fled the scene. Mr. Musa Amulu, one of the eight survivors, said that soil caved in abruptly, giving no room for the six to escape. Our team, of course, from our sister station, Bukede, was on ground, and they managed to get a story for us, despite the hurdles coming in from the police.
Abazimbi mukaga bakakasudde okubanga bafiride mu kizimbe ekibadde kizimbibwa e Kansanga mu ggombolola y'e Makindye mu Kampala. Ekizimbe kino kibadde kikyali ku musingi olw'ettaka eryasimiddwa ne litendebwa lyo ne libuutikira ababadde bazimba.
Ababadde babadde bakola nabo bazze ne batugamba wabwerufe nti ettaka libuutikidde bannaffe ne bafiirayo munda.
Basatu ku bo babadde badduse mu malwaliro ag'enjawulo ng'embeera yaabwe mbi. Abantu ababeera okutya n'ekizimbe kino oluwulidde bino ne baagala okutaasa bannaabwe ekyokka olutuuseeyo ab'ebyokwerinda ne bannannyini kizimbe ne babalemesa okuyingira era ebifaananyi tubikwatidde wala.
Bafande batugala baagala bujulizi kati obujulizi babukwata te bagoba bannamawulire baagala ki?
Abantu boogedde kyebasuubira okuviirako ettaka okubuutikira abantu ne bavumira n'ekya poliisi okubagaana okutaasa bannaabwe.
Ebizimbe ebigwira abantu olw'okuba tebalinaki bikozesebwa be bandikozeseza nga bali mu ttaka eryo ettaka bandibadde baitekako ebyuma ne byanga birikute ne litakomawo bagwira.
Wabaddewo katemba nga poliisi egezaako okugoba abantu ku bizimba waggulu bwe babadde balabira ebigenda mu maaso era yadde ereese eddaala okuyamba abantu okukka wansi bagaanye ne biweereza ebisongovu. Abawonyeewo bannyonnyodde ekibaddewo.
Bwe tubeeredde awo nga bannaffe bakola eri kubanga mbadde ndese sinu naye mbadde nnyimiridde nga ntunudde eri ekintu ne kiyimbuluka lumu ne kigwayo nnyola kwe tutuusibwako kubanze mbadde ebbali abadduse badduse kati baba tabadde mufa bawonyewo naye nga mukaaga bagenzi.
Abafiiriddwa abantu baabwe bakukulumidde poliisi olw'okubagaana okuyingira okujiyimirambo.
Ngaffe abantu abamu nga tulina abantu baffe bafudde yandibadde batukkiriza kuyingirayo ne tulaba kiri awo ekigenda maaso.
Poliisi yabazimya moto eyikudde ettaka okujiyimirambo ng'oluvannyuma balesika banga ly'ekitutte mu ggwanika e Mulago. Amyuka akulira poliisi y'abazima moto Hassan Jihanda akasiza abafudde ne poliisi byekoze okutaasa abalala.
Ne tukola emitendo gyaffe egya rolokolinga bakozi kuva mafoamani abameka bazi leero bameka abaliwo kati ne tusanga nga abakozi mukaaga tibarabika. Ne tutandika kubanoonya ne skaveta era twagyeyo emirambo egyo mukaaga.
Agamba bakyagenda mu maaso n'okunoonya nannyini kizimba omutuufu.
Of course, once such tragedies occur, the owners of the scene, the site, disappear. We just say UK, UK, UK. So we don't know which actually is the UK. But they shall definitely get there.
Yudaya Namialo, Yakusaki Degwe, Mkulabu Kede TV.
A very unfortunate incident happening right there, of course, claiming six people's lives down in March India Division. But our conversation for this particular morning, moving away from that one, is why are buildings collapsing in the country? We need to understand what exactly goes wrong. Now, back to our table of discussion. I want to begin with you, Tina. What do you think is going on? What do you think is befalling us as far as, you know, these buildings collapsing is concerned?
Simple. Corruption.
Corruption?
Kanjikuletere mungeri nyangwe.
Please.
If KCCA and their building plans and all that whole hassle you have to go through to erect a building in this here country was up to par and up to standard, we wouldn't see particular things. Bova kwecho, if KCCA again, because when you put in, when you submit for a building permit, that you're going to build a place, there are particular safety precautions and measures that you are supposed to cover and go through. They are guidelines they give you.
Okay.
But no one is looking out for those. No one is going to come to the site and be like, okay, wanowali wabi, this is dangerous for our safety precaution, this is that. You just get a bunch of people who are looking for jobs. None of them even has that much expertise. All they know is at the end of the day, I'm going to get a quick back and go have a meal. That's what they're thinking. Now, it goes back without, there's no one else we can blame but the city council that is responsible, because this is not even in the outskirts of Kampala, it is in the city. Which means, by the time this guy bought this land, submitted and said, this is my proposed building, they're going to ask him, where is your project building plan? Where is it? Then after that, they're going to ask him, so site, you're going to building plan here, wait. Which means they have to give you, there are regulations for all these things. Scotty, if someone is seated in their office and UK, just gets the right amount of money and says, go. No one is coming to like honestly inspect these different things that are happening in the city. Like anyone can build at this point. And what's sad, it's the commercial buildings and the plazas. We take our time. Which means the onus is not on us, the people, to find out why it's happening. The onus is on KCC to sit back and go like, wait, we need to be a little more, you know,
vigilant
than we are, because that's it. Even the building that fell in Bukota, I remember I was living, I was just passing the place when it all just crumbled down and fell. And the Bukota guys were like, "Hicho chizimbe bachizimbi de wiki ezo."
Willis, I want us to look at, you know, the people involved as far as, you know, buildings are concerned here in the city. You have, you know, the workers on site. You have the engineers that are going to come through. You have, you know, the KCCA contractors that, you know, she's talking about. Who do you think is entirely to blame for such buildings or is collapsing?
Well, I think that our leaders have failed us. And also the people responsible for standards have also failed us. Because they work in the city. They live in the city. The things that they oversee are also in the city.
Yeah.
But to see that you reach on at a site where people are constructing and porters do not have helmets, just as simple as helmets, is very sickening. You see 10, 20 young people, very energetic. They are carrying heavy things without gloves, you understand? So those are the small nitty-gritties that if you compound and build up, you get such situations. So it's not just about, you know, the building falling is not just about the plans, but also those small little few nitty-gritties that when they are building the foundation of a very tall building, they go deep. But if they go deep, they do not have safety mechanisms. Because if you're going deep, definitely it's going to sort of fall in. What are the safety mechanisms that are being put in place? Our leaders, the people who have authorized these buildings, they are not inspecting these places from time to time.
Okay.
I would give you an example. If you look at the constructions that are being spearheaded by the Chinese, if you reach those sites, the Chinese are, you know, dressed and protected to their teeth. You understand? They have helmets, gloves, gun boots, overalls. They are protected to the teeth. But when you look at the Ugandans working at the same site, A guy is kakofira na ka ovro.
You understand? Not even,
yeah, with boots. Mm. But you see, we are putting ourselves at risk. Mm. Because, like it or not, buildings can fall. That is nature. Accidents can happen. Just on Christmas Eve, there's a building along Chanja Road. A guy built a very long fence that, you know, it just fell. The fence was okay. It was good material and everything. Mm. But, you know, calamity, you know, incidents happen. So it happened and it fell. Mm. You can't, you know, run away from accidents. Mm. But how prepared are we to take care of the accidents? Mm. You understand? Mm. So we are taking these things for granted. The people who are authorizing these plans are not doing us service.
Okay. And in the end,
young
office.
People are dying. Mm, mm. Because I can imagine those six people that died, unfortunately, did not have these protective gears. If they had, if someone had a helmet, maybe a stone would have hit him and he would have saved his head. You understand?
Talking about services and, of course, stakeholders that are involved in these buildings, you cannot go away without, you know, highlighting UNBS, which is in charge of, you know, you know, understanding the kind of quality of materials that people are using for building. Talk about cement, bricks, and everything. Would you entirely also somehow, somewhere blame UNBS?
I think with the
passing, you know, probably
No. I think with the because we had I think two buildings in the past where we had substandard construction
materials.
But then I think with those incidences, I think we've learned and moved in the right direction. I don't think the material that was being used in this particular issue or in the buildings around are substandard. I think we are just being lazy and careless about our own lives and the lives of the people at these sites.
Okay.
I think that for me is the problem. Mm-hmm. If you move around these sites, it's only the poor man who is protected, as if the poor man is the one who is carrying the bricks. You understand? So we get it the other way around. The poor man actually can show up in a suit. He's descending in like an office, in like a container. Mm-hmm. But the person we need to protect is the porter, the person who is digging. Mm-hmm. You're holding
ensururu.
That way in a glove. Or segera. Kati wakube ensururu e jinjaneri kusala. Paka luofa. You understand? So we are taking our lives for granted. The lives of the people who are working at these sites are for granted.
Okay.
Because I believe that if these guys were protected, we would have, you know, be having a different scenario right now. Someone would have been saved, or maybe there would be nursing injuries. It would not be death. But, you know, it's unfortunate that, you know,
Tina, what are some of the things we need to put into consideration as far as measurements are concerned to avoid this kind of calamities happening within the city?
I think one, as Nga Willis Wagambi, we need to protect ourselves. I think one, if you are a resident, Olina Agamba, Tugenda Zimbabwe, Chizimbe, now we're better vigilant enough for Kubuzo wa council. Aha, Bagenda Zimbabwe, Bagenda Kuteka Obani. Do they have building plans?
Yeah.
Does KCCA approve? Does it have the right standards? Mm. Let's now start policing on our own level, because at the end of the day, Bagenda Zimbabwe, Bigwira either mwababi kolam or bababidi nanye. And then most importantly, I think a very honest, open conversation needs to be had with particular authorities and bodies. I know how we are seated and we're on Twitter and we tweet and tag at them. I think we need to have more get-togethers, you know. KCCA to Lewalinga Sita Square. And let us address particular things.
There's a building that was being erected, I think, in Old Kampala. I don't know if this guy wanted to squeeze a parking lot under some other guy's building.
But,
when you look at it, you see the other guy's building is here. Then I guess I could remain. You see, people are going to die. It's either the people working at the site or maybe the building will, you know.
Where are we leaving the engineers in this conversation?
These
are the people that will give you a plan.
The engineers are doing their jobs properly.
Exactly.
The architects are designing properly. The engineers are coming to scout the sites and
properly,
you know, do the mixing properly.
Just like the workers?
Yes. The people who are failing us are two ends. One, the owners of these premises.
Thank you.
First of all, they are taking health and safety for granted.
Okay. Thank
you. So you find that there's a construction site. There's no one responsible for health and safety there. Uh-huh. Because they think, everyone can take care of themselves. Tolaba, gotola antio stude, chikutia chinene, wachute weti sachi into. So we are taking health and safety for granted. And that's to the owners of these buildings. But also, the people who are supposed to be policing the construction of these buildings are also letting us down. When they pass and approve these plans, they go back to their SEs and wait for the next plan.
And ask for tea.
So at the end of the day, we are the ones who are being affected. And like Tina said, I think that we as citizens ought to start. You know, olabe tikatingecho chenalaba simanyo bachagwa na yinga ndabira
na
musajja akukusaka parking akateka once we chizimbe
omanyinga kwa at least not even only that I know there are times when we even see them on social media and we laugh where you'll see someone honestly build something that shouldn't even be there and then we turn it into a meme forgetting if anything goes haywire with these pouring rains with so many things are shifting that could be a tragedy so I think policing comes with us. If someone is erecting a building close to you, mwebuze building plan and niaja approves. On top of who approved it, get down to the nitty gritty. Go to the local council and ask bana ichizimbe chawali. Tetuina gafira wantu. I think one thing as Ugandans that we have failed to do is to learn how to police for ourselves. We always want to sit back and just be like, governmenti, tena chafiambi, tena chakoze. But in actual sense, we need to be there for us. Baba inokwe sotinga at times.
Inokwe bedelam.
Yeah.
All right. And also at this point in time, we'd like to ask that everyone that is, you know, involved in working at this particular building, please make sure that you have the safety gears you need. These things are not quite expensive. If your owner, employer cannot give them to you and you feel like you need that, come and invest in yourself. Ogule helmet yuebe idao, manyenti nzedi muzimbi, kasababawa, kalimo, teka up test helmet, yange, nina gloves, yange, nina gumboots, yange. Yeah. Wabedelemu, you need to be on the lookout.
Omayokuwa wena ingida, I started part-timing in gardening. Neche naso kukola. Kugula bikozesebwa ebyo binkuuma nali natera okugula magosi protector.
Ani?
Ojimani. Abazanyi ba cricket. You know when you're playing cricket, cricket is a hard
game.
So you have a helmet, shin guards and everything. Then you have what we call in the cricket language, magosi protector. It's like a box. Bajita asa.
Ngachikwatawa.
Chikwata... In the government, it protects the government.
Because I want
government
to know
want
the
government,
private, the part government that it calls, I want it to sound like the sound.
What can I say? What can I say? it protects the government.
Which government?
Yeah, but
the local
Derek,
government.
I think Derek, you're right when you say that. You know, if your employer is not in position to provide
to give
some
the safety gears, yes.
I think it was your. You've chosen a hassle to say you're going to do this probably 3 years. So you need to protect yourself. Buy the helmet, buy the gloves, you know, buy everything, buy the boots, so that even when you come to apply for a job, Gaya Gamba, you're serious.
We understand January could be tough, but it should be something that you're saving for. At this point in time, we're going for a very quick break. When we do get back, we flip the script. It will be the second hour of the show. And this time around, we're looking into some love relationship crisis.